In their last game, the Rangers watched the Flyers score once and then again in what became Philly's first win. At 1-3, the Rangers know tonight would be a great time to get the season headed in a different direction. The New York Rangers are presented by Chase, and tonight an original six matchup as the Rangers face the Toronto Maple Leafs for the first time this season. Good evening, everybody. I'm Al Trawick. Think of what goes into a winning hockey season. Certainly offense, defense, goaltending, a power play, a penalty kill, a ferociousness, and just a little bit of arrogance that the Rangers are missing. But you only get the arrogance if you win hockey games. And that is the catch-22 that the Rangers find themselves in tonight. We'll see if they can overcome that. For more, we go to Sam Rosen and Joe Micheletti. Sam?
Thanks very much, Al. Good evening, everyone. And Al's right. The Rangers not happy in the room at all about the way they played the first four games. But here's the stretch coming up with three straight home games where they have a chance to turn it around.
Well, we've talked about it often. When they lost last year in the playoffs, they were upset. They thought they had a chance to win it. So there was anticipation coming into this season. And John Tortorella, the coach, told us tonight before the game that he notices that within the room, that they don't have the same confidence that they had before. They're trying to get it back.
Now, there have been a couple of bright spots, not a whole lot of them, but if you look at the free agent acquisition, Taylor Pyatt, he scored three goals. He's been present, been a good presence around the net. And the goaltending of Henrik Lundqvist, including the last, especially the last two games, has been very good.
That one big surprise, one no surprise for the most part. As far as Taylor Pyatt is concerned, he was brought in here to be a third, fourth line player. Well, now he's up to the second line, and why not? He has scored goals now in three consecutive games. He's a big body. He even said that he was tired on Friday because he's not used to playing 18, 19 minutes a game. He was playing 12 to 13 while he was in Phoenix. He's been terrific thus far. Now, as far as Henrik Lundqvist, we saw the save of the year in the first game of the season in Boston with that tremendous save on Krejci. And to me, Sam, he looks like he's getting better and better, and I thought his performance in Philly was excellent.
Well, what's the feeling in the locker room? That's what we wanted to know. John Gianone caught up with Rangers captain Brian Callahan just a few minutes ago outside the locker room, and they talked about getting this turned around.
The Rangers play home game number three tonight at the Garden. Ryan, after taking Friday to rest and contemplate where you guys are at so far, what stands out to you about what's either been right or wrong?
Well, I think, you know, there's been a bit of both. You know, I think we got to try to put a, you know, 60 minutes of right hockey together. And, you know, I think that is getting pucks deep and being consistent in our defensive zone, creating chances. And, you know, with the guys we have in there, if we do that and, you know, we bring our battle level up, I think we'll be successful.
And you've been one of the guys who has talked about battle level after a couple of the losses. What is the key to ensuring that as a team the battle level increases?
You know, I think it starts individually, just concentrating on each individual battle. And, you know, as a group, you know, that'll improve. And, you know, it's part of our identity we've tried to create here over the last couple of years. And when we're doing that, when we're playing that style of hockey, we're a tough team to beat.
It is still early as far as the calendar goes, but I guess it's never too early when you start to lose a couple of games. As the captain, do you think at this point there's something either to say or do, or is it still in your mind too early?
No, I mean, you never want to lose, you know, three out of four or whatever it is. I mean, you know, no matter if it's the start of the season, middle of the season, or the end of the season. And, you know, something needs to get fixed here. We need to righten the ship. And, you know, no better place to do it tonight.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
And tonight's opponent, the Toronto Maple Leafs, with two wins on the season. Both of those have come on the road.
Thanks, John. And yes, the Toronto Maple Leafs are 2-2. Their head coach, Randy Carlyle, says they played three good games. Last game against the Islanders, not so good. But it's a dangerous team. Here's our Land Rover scouting report. It features the high-scoring winger, Phil Kessel, who's got great speed, and the youngster, a centerman, Nazem Kadri, who's starting to come into his own. He has 5 points in the first four games.
Yeah, it's interesting, Sam. This is a team that can really skate. That's why John Tortorella told us they want to get into a grinding, hitting game. As far as Phil Kessel, he has not scored a goal yet this season, and that is unusual for him. He's notoriously a very fast starter, but he leads him in shots on goal with 20. He's had a lot of chances, they're just not going in yet. Now, Nazem Kadri, he was their number one pick a couple of years ago, and this is a kid that is, as you mentioned, he's coming into his own. The coach has given him a lot of confidence. He's worked hard in the minors prior to this season starting, and now he leads them in points.
Now, Head coach John Tortorella of the Rangers told us this is a fast team. How do the Rangers deal with that Toronto speed?
Hit. I mean, they've got to hit and they've got to control the puck. And even the players on the Rangers are talking about, we're not taking control of the game because when we get the puck, we're giving it away. We're not playing in the offensive zone. Toronto will have trouble getting going if you can keep it in their end and put pressure on their defense.
Rangers need some contributions up and down the lineup. Could Brian Boyle and Carl Hagelin be those guys who emerge in tonight's game? We'll talk more about Boyle and Hagelin and their contributions right after these messages. Welcome back to Madison Square Garden. We're moments away from the start of tonight's game between the Rangers and the Toronto Maple Leafs. Closed captioning tonight is brought to you by the New York Lottery. Hey, you never know. We're just a couple of minutes away from the opening faceoff. We talked about the Rangers needing contributions up and down the line. And to me, Joe, one of the key guys is Brian Boyle because of his physical presence.
Well, we got used to Brian Boyle a couple of years ago, not only with the physical presence, but also blocking shots, scoring goals, being a good defender, playing against the other team's top players. And it's been a struggle for him this year, also, you know, with Hagelin as well. But for Brian Boyle and John Tortorella, remember he talked to us the other day about having trust in his players, and we saw him go with two lines there for a while in the third period against Philadelphia. These players need to start playing better so that he trusts them and it'll be a more of a balance.
And Brian Boyle is one of our key players tonight. Tonight's key players are presented by Sports Yapper, the free app for talking about tonight's game. Get it now on sportsyapper.com. Brian Boyle and the other man we talked about is Carl Hagelin, who coming into the season, the coaches felt he could be one of the top six forwards on this team.
Well, he showed as a rookie that he's got obviously great speed. He scored early, but he hasn't scored late, and that's been an issue. So if John Tortorella wants to try and keep those big three together like he's done before, it would be much easier for the team to be able to keep them together if they're getting contributions from other people. A second line, you need a little bit more, but that third line's not giving them anything on the offensive side, and you certainly need that. Carl Hagelin, he worked hard in the offseason. He came to camp, and even Brad Richards said he looks like a better player, but he hasn't scored yet, and they need that third line to produce.
You think he's been a little tight, a little nervous, moved up to that first or second line?
I think it kind of fits with the rest of the team right now. I mean, here's a kid that came off the first year, and now he gets put in that top line, as you mentioned. And I would say, yeah, he is. I mean, this is the speed, and he knows he needs to contribute, and he's still a young player. Brian Boyle's been around long enough to know that he needs to do some other things. He needs to win some more faceoffs. He needs to play more physical. And when he's playing that way, then what ends up happening is the offense follows him. After he takes care of the defensive side, the offense comes his way.
First of three straight home games for the Rangers, and a chance to right things. They're 1-3 and taking on a good-looking Toronto Maple Leafs team. We'll be set to go with the opening faceoff at Madison Square Garden in just a moment. Back in Madison Square Garden, Sam Rosen, Joe Micheletti, John Gino, Rangers and Toronto Maple Leafs getting set for their first meeting. And let's take a look at our Audi goaltending matchup once again. His fifth consecutive start in goal, Henrik Lundqvist. The numbers don't look Lundqvist-like, but the last two games he's been very, very good. And across the way is James Reimer, maybe the biggest question mark about the Toronto Maple Leafs this season will be their goaltending.
Oh, for sure, Sam, and that's why there's been so much talk about Roberto Luongo. And, you know, will he be someone who, of course, Luongo's in Vancouver right now and didn't play last night in Vancouver's 5-0 win in Anaheim.
Yeah, that's been the big story and something that we'll have to watch. Rangers open with their top line of Brad Richards, Marion Gaborik, and Rick Nash. On defense, Michael Delzato and Mark Stahl. And the Leafs open up with Phil Kessel, Clark MacArthur, and Tyler Bozak. And on defense, Dion Phaneuf and Mike Kostak. Has been a very impressive rookie.
27-year-old rookie, Sam. Played at University of Massachusetts at Amherst. Kicking around the American League a little bit. But he had a very good start to this season, playing for the Toronto Marlies in the American Hockey League. 34 points in 34 games, and he's been very good on this defense pairing.
Rangers have made a quick change, Leafs as well. Hrabowski got knocked down along the boards by Ryan Callahan, and Callahan gets called for boarding. 1:07 into the game, Rangers will be shorthanded.
This is 4 out of 5 games now where we've seen the Rangers take an early penalty. There's the hit. Hrabowski was facing the glass. You got to just try and hold up if you can, and the players feel it. Down they go, and so the Rangers shorthanded early.
And you know, Joe, with Brian Callahan, he just wants to make something happen early, something positive, and unfortunately, the hit from behind becomes a boarding penalty.
And Sam, what's going on now in the league is they're calling more penalties. The penalties called are up this year. Power play chances are up this year. The referees are really keeping a close eye on every aspect of the game.
Girardi and McDonough, Haglin and Boyle, the penalty killers for the Rangers. John Tortorella telling us before the game he wants better penalty killing from Boyle and Haglin. Feels they need to be involved a little bit more. Quick change brings on Jeff Halpern and Rick Nash getting penalty killing time. Nash with a puck here. He's had a shorthanded goal this season. And the Rangers kill some time as it's fired ahead by McDonough, deflected to Halpern.
And they're taking advantage of Toronto making a change as well. Very smart play by Nash. And then the same with Halpern.
John Michael Lyles, number 24, with the puck. Mike Costa, number 53, playing the points. Up front, they have Mikhail Hrabowski, the former Flyer, James Van Riemsdyk, number 21, and Clark MacArthur. There's Costa, out to him, Haglin. Haglin and Stepan are on. That shot blocked by Staal, who clears it. Good block, good clear. Staal and Delzato are on.
Excellent penalty killing to start this game.
30 seconds to go in the Leafs power play. 2:40 gone by first period. Gunnarsson moves it up to Hrabowski. And Van Riemsdyk swings it around the board. Staal there to try and drive it around. Didn't get it cleanly. But Halpern helped out. The puck's out of the zone. Van Riemsdyk sends it back in. Staal pressured by MacArthur. Delzato drives it out. That'll do it. Outstanding penalty kill, no shots on goal for the Leafs.
And Sam, you know what that was? That was read and react by all the penalty killers for the Rangers. Someone would make a decisive decision, the other players would react, and they gave Toronto absolutely nothing.
Leafs back at full strength. On the puck, Nazem Kadri. Kadri, first round draft pick in 2009 for the Leafs, 7th overall. Nash with a takeaway, leads the rush. Drops it off to Gavrik. Now the trailer, McDonough, save, rebound, was blocked in the crowd at the goal line.
How did that not go in?
Kadri the other way, pass in front, shot went wide on the deflection. There's the outlet, it's batted down by Koska, intended for Nash. Wow, that was some good end-to-end action. There were three players piled up at the goal line. Uh-oh, gloves dropped. Mike Brown for Toronto. And Aaron Asham for the Rangers. Asham just back in the lineup. Well, in the Pittsburgh game, Aaron Asham waited 2 seconds. In this game, 3:59 to get involved. No,
anxious to get back in there. Meanwhile, Sam, what a chance for the Rangers. There was a collision in front. Excellent puck movement, and you can see in the background Ryan McDonough following up the play. He'll get the shot, and then there's that chance. Who did it hit? It must have hit, I don't know if it hit the goaltender. I think it hit either the Ranger player Nash or the defenseman for Toronto.
I think you're right about that. John Tortorella It's interesting listening to him on the pregame show, Joe, you know, where he's wrestling with trying to be patient and yet trying to be tough when he has to be.
Yeah. Well, he's such an intense coach. And now you've got, here we go, Orr.
Colton Orr and Mike Rupp.
Yeah, this is the fourth time in their careers that they have fought.
Orr's had a couple of fights early this season. Colton Orr in a contract year. He wants to make sure people see him and recognize who he is. He worked out in Connecticut during the lockout.
With Marty St. Louis and Max Pacioretty. And this was, they were ready to go before they dropped the puck. They had to wait for the puck to drop. Rupp was telling me this morning, he said, with Colton Orr, he says, he doesn't like to be patient. He likes to come at you. So he said in previous fights, he's been able to hold him off a little bit with his long reach. And meanwhile, here's the chance for Richards. Oh, see, it hits the defenseman.
Yeah.
Going into the, I mean, what a chance.
That was from our Lexus super slow-mo camera.
We got some action going here, don't we, in the first?
Now on the ice is number 36, Ben Ferriero, who was acquired in a minor league trade earlier this week. He was playing in the Penguins organization at Wilkes-Barre in the American League. Chad Kolarik was sent from the Connecticut Whale to the Penguins organization. Ferriero played for the Connecticut Whale last night. And he played earlier this week for Wilkes-Barre. he's played with his third different team in the last four nights.
He's been playing. He's got some offensive ability. He's a quick skater. Not great size, about 185 pounds.
Was a teammate of Brian Boyle's at Boston College. Bozak had it knocked away.
Yeah, for 2 years they played together.
Back the other way, Rick Nash. He's knocked down by Dion Phaneuf. There's a heavyweight matchup right there. Two all-star players. We are 5:15 into the game. There's no score. Rangers have the only shots on goal. They have three. Leafs have yet to get a shot on goal. There's Lyles. The outlet for Kessel. Kessel finds the trailer. Bozak, that shot was deflected.
Boy, they get up and down the ice quickly, don't they?
Quick. Carl Gunnarsson with a shot. That's blocked by Delzato. Koska to Gunnarsson. Back to Mike Koska. Rister was blocked. Rangers take it away. Nash has been very good all over the ice. Loose puck.
Well, Sam, part of the pregame meeting that Toronto had, they talked about Nash and they said, this guy is so good one-on-one. Just be alert and be aware of what he can do by himself.
Girardi comes over from the collision with Kuhlman. Bobrovsky is bumped by Haglund. Gonna try to clear. Knocked down by Nikolai Kuhlman. Finds Lyles. Lyles finds a man in front. They score! Mikhail Grabowski. A beautiful feed from John Michael Lyles. And the Leafs on their first shot on goal score to take the lead.
Now turnover by the Rangers. McDonough will get it. He's looking for someone. He gets pressure. Toronto keeps it in, and now this is just a defensive mistake. Two players, both, you see McDonough and Girardi in the same spot. They forgot to look behind them where Grabowski was, and Grabowski's excellent hands and quickness had way too much time. And so from a turnover to a defensive mistake to a 1-0 deficit.
I thought I read the lips of Coach John Tortorella behind the bench saying too wide open. I wonder if he feels the Rangers are getting too much up and down the ice.
That makes sense, Sam, because as he told us, he wants to play more of a grinding game.
Shot by Callahan deflects into the corner. Mike Komisarek, who did not play in the last game against the Islanders, back in. That shot by Strollman is a save by Reimer. And we have a get together in front of the crease. Play stops. 6:52 gone by.
Mikhail Grabowski is given the lead to 1-0 lead.
Here's another look at the goal for Toronto. As they're able to carry it in the zone, everything at this point looks fine. Now, if we stop it here, here's Dan Girardi. He's over here so that he's hoping he can get the puck. But because of the pressure on McDonough, now if we stop it here, you see both players go for the puck carrier. They forget about Grabowski behind him. Little lack of communication there, Sam, as to who's going to take the puck carrier and who's going to cover up in front of the net. It turns out, give Toronto credit. Nice offensive zone play that led to the goal.
Grabowski from Lyles and Kuhlman at 6:25, giving the Leafs the 1-0 lead. Girardi. All the way down it goes. Gunnarsson touches up for an icing. Tonight on MSG Plus, join Al Troutwig, Dave Maloney, Billy Jaffe, Ken Danico for post-game analysis of the Rangers and the Leafs. Plus, they'll take you around the NHL. Get everything you need to know about what's going on in the league. It's Hockey Night Live. That's tonight, right after the game here on MSG Plus. Komisarek toward the net. Just went wide. Lundqvist was screened on the play. Kessel tried to center, deflected away and out of the zone. Komisarek sends it to Gunnarsson and lifts it into the Rangers bench.
Mike Komisarek, the Long Island kid, has not played a home game yet. He's playing all road games.
It's interesting.
He's trying to get his game back together. You know, he had a tough season last year. He was a big free agent signing a few years ago. And, you know, they're really working to try and get him back to the level that he played at when he was with the Montreal Canadiens.
It's a tough crowd in Toronto. And they expected a lot of things. That puck deflects off the stick of Rick Nash up into the crowd.
Now, Sam, it's an interesting start to this game. The Rangers have had 5 shots. We showed the excellent opportunity by Brad Richards to score, which would have given the Rangers a lead. That doesn't go in. Toronto comes back with 1 chance. It's been their only shot on goal in this period, and it ends up in their net.
A turnover, and it's in the net. Delzato and Stahl paired on defense.
Now, Sam, we saw that goal, and a lot of players have been talking about hesitation. Too much of that.
Here's Nash. Nice move, and then he lost it.
What a play by Koska. Looked like he was beaten. He uses his stick to turn the other way and poke it off the stick of Nash.
Richards banked it off the back of the net. Nash after it. Richards back in there against Pinot. Now Nash in the corner. Stahl toward the net. Blocked in front by Koska. Koska has looked very good.
He really has.
Yeah.
Jan Pinot, when we were talking to him before the game, he was raving about how smart he is and how well they fit in together.
Richards, good takeaway in the corner. Now Pinot able to move it and find Van Riemsdyk. Out to Nikolai Kuhlman. Down the middle goes Koska, the defenseman. That shot blocked by Stahl. Taken by Grabowski. Lyles ahead for Koska. Koska's shot to the side of the net, deflected by Kuhlman. And taken away by Delzato. Zotto lifts in, goes for a change. Ferriero, number 36 in Akron. Played parts of 3 seasons with the San Jose Sharks. After coming out of college at Boston College, originally a Phoenix draft pick, but never played for Phoenix. Boyle, the line is Boyle, Haglin, and Ferriero. Here's Haglin. The shot by Strahlman was high as he just got underneath it. Karamov moving in. It's Leo Karamov. A shot from the point by Mark Fraser was blocked. Boyle trying to play it. Used the body well. Good job by Ryan Boyle. Coming down to the midway point, first period. Gunnarsson off the boards. Down to the Rangers' zone. Icing against Toronto. With 10:12 to go here in the first period.
Now, Koska must have been listening to his coach when he said, watch this guy, what a play. He had gone down to one knee to block the shot, and watch how he spins and uses the stick. That's a brilliant play by this 27-year-old rookie. Now, they've done a good job Toronto has. As far as keeping shots against them down, that's been a real area of emphasis for Randy Carlyle and his coaching staff.
You saw the Leafs bench tapping their sticks along the boards. Colton Orr had come out of the penalty box. Got some cheers from his teammates. As did Mike Brown. After their fighting majors. Rangers had Asham and Rupp involved.
The new daddy, Colton Orr.
That's right.
He had a daughter. He and his wife, Sabrina, had a daughter, Charlotte.
On October 31st.
Yep.
Trick or treat. It was some treat.
For sure.
MacArthur, number 16 for Toronto. Bozak plays it across. Here comes Komisarek. All the way around it goes. Rangers five shots on goal. Leafs only one. Up the boards for Rick Nash. Nash moves in on Koska all the way through to Gavrik. Quick shot high. Bozak fires it out. Lozado reaches for it. Kessel would be offside. Couldn't touch the puck. Nice lead. Nash to the net. Good save by Reimer. A beauty to rob Rick Nash. Rangers getting some chances. Rick Nash moves in on James Reimer. Reimer robs him. Back at the Garden, it's time for Between the Benches, brought to you by Ford. Check out the best-selling vehicles in America. Visit your tri-state Ford dealer today. Here's John Chianone. John.
Yes, and there's about a novel's worth of stuff that's been written in this first 11-plus minutes of the first period, and we invite all the viewers to share their thoughts and comments on Twitter. Use the hashtag NYR. Dave Maloney will be in studio with us between periods to talk about it, and send your questions as well for our between-period guests. It'll be Brian Boyle in the first, and Jersey Boy James Van Riemsdyk will join us in the second.
Thanks, John. John with a great view of things between the benches. Eavesdropping.
He's right in the middle of the action.
Can't get any closer. Van Riemsdyk away with the puck. What do you think of that trade, though? Van Riemsdyk coming to Toronto from Philadelphia.
Well, you had two teams that had a need.
There's Gavrik moving in, but he's stopped by Koska again.
You know, Sam, you talked about the Toronto fans. Luke Shen was not a favorite there, and it was, he's still a young defenseman. Philadelphia needed some strength in a defenseman, and they had a surplus of forwards. So Van Riemsdyk, I think it turned out to be a good trade for both teams.
Richards pass tipped into the zone by Callahan. Enough back for it. Callahan rides into the boards. Koska's outlet was past Mike Brown all the way down. The race for the puck. Girardi gets there for an icing touch-up. Just under 8 minutes to go in the first.
Sam, the Rangers have had six shots on goal. How about this pass here? Now, you're going to see Toronto go for a change. And here's Nash, who's just going to come right to the middle of the ice. Delzato's going to see him. Perfect pass. Now he's got time and room. And James Reimer, boy, what a glove save. It's the first time Reimer's ever played against the Rangers. And he's had a good first period.
Mike Brown moves in for the faceoff against Derek Stepan. Steve Eminger. Eminger and Stallman on for the Rangers on defense. Taylor Pyatt is on with Stepan and Callahan. A long shot knocked down in front. Reimer lost sight of it momentarily. Leafs able to clear out. Leafs have had only one shot on goal in this period. That came off a turnover, and it went in the net. That's the 1-0 lead. Mikhail Grabowski scoring. Good job by the Rangers along the wall. Step on for Callahan at the side of the net. Trying to sweep it into the crease. He did, and Reimer was able to block it. And Callahan is challenged by Brown and Koska.
And then get some help from Taylor Pyatt, jumps in. Now, the Rangers have done a lot of good things in this period. They really have. One shot against. Their penalty killing was good. Callahan's just in the middle of everything. Yeah. Here's a good forecheck, something they wanted to do a much better job. of. And that one goes off. It actually goes off the skate of Koska. And then here's Brown. And Koska gets involved. Taylor Pyatt jumps in. But that was part of what their thinking and talks have been about, it holding on to the puck in the offensive zone and making plays.
They've had more time in the offensive zone. They've had good puck possession. They've had some good scoring chances. And right now, trail 1-0. And again, the Rangers able to play the faceoff. Delzato keeps it in and takes a hit from Leo Komarov, number 47.
He leads them in hits.
Penalty upcoming on the Leafs. A hooking call.
Yeah, Fratton, I believe.
And the Rangers will get a power play. Matt Fratton goes off.
Yeah, Fratton used the speed to try and close in, but there it is, right up in the hands. That's a hooking call. As I mentioned earlier, Sam, penalties are up. Fighting majors are double what they were a year ago. I mean, everybody in the league's fighting, it seems like.
So now the Rangers with a power play opportunity. Another thing that needs improvement in this early part of the season. Rangers have Richards, Callahan, and Nash with Girardi and Delzato.
Yeah, and that's part of the problem, is winning faceoffs and getting control of the puck. Bolzak was out there taking the faceoff for Toronto, wins it, and then heads to the bench.
Delzato with Nikolai Kuhlman all over him. On the boards to Girardi. Fratton for hooking at 12:56. Rangers' first power play of the game. Nash carries across. Callahan. Enough stopped him. Nash shoots, save, Reimer. Nash. And the puck taken and cleared all the way down.
Now, John Tortorella has talked about, you know, the special teams, the power play in particular, just needing to get more shots.
Gavrik with Taylor Pyatt and Derek Stepan. Strahlman at the right point. Delzato stays on. Here's Strahlman faking. Shot by Gavrik. Save. Rebound. Pyatt blocked. Kovacera kicks it away. Played by Gavrik. Stepan sets up Strahlman. The shot blocked in front and cleared by Van Riemsdyk.
Now that's a new change for the Rangers power play. He's having Strahlman on the point.
And taking Gavrik off from Richards and Nash. Here's Strahlman with a keep in. The setup for Pyatt, rather. It was Stahl who's on and took that last shot. Strahlman and Stahl at the points now. 25 seconds to go on the power play. Pyatt takes a hit from Kuhlman. Blocked the clearing attempt. Stepan around the boards to Gavrik. Back to Strahlman. Now to Stahl. Stahl has some room. He shoots. Saved by Reimer. Rangers crowded the net. Taylor Pyatt did a good job in front.
Well, both these power play units, I think, have done a nice job. And you can really tell. They're trying to get. There's a big hit by Stahl on Koska. But I just think they're being more decisive as far as trying to get shots through. That was the last shot by Mark Stahl with Pyatt in front.
Now Haglund, Boyle, and Ferriero come on with Girardi and McDonough as the power play expires. But a pretty good power play, I thought, Joe.
I did too.
Three shots on goal on that power play. Good chances. Here's Boyle to the net. Reimer made the save. Girardi with a wrister. That's knocked down. And Kessel has the puck.
Reimer's had a good period. Really good period.
4:40 to go. They've tried to build his time up and is getting it back into good game shape.
Now, Sammy had gone over 300 days between starts. I mean, he had head problems, neck problems a year ago.
Ben Scrivens, the number two goaltender, we got a whistle. They're pointing at the Rangers bench. Were there too many men on the ice? Not sure. It might be. 4:21 to go in the first.
Sam, you're good in math. How many blue dots?
I see six plus a goalie.
too many.
That's right.
John Giannone has more. John.
Yeah, guys, what happened was Ben Ferriero had circled to the far end of the bench near me, looked like he was coming off the ice, then stayed on. Aaron Ashton was at the opposite end of the bench, thought he was coming off, he jumped on. That's what ended up having too many men, and Ferriero is the one serving the penalty.
Thanks, John. Too many men on the ice at 15:39. Leafs, second power play, 0-for-1. Leafs have only one shot on goal. That shot by Fedot goes wide. But that one shot was a goal by Mikhail Grabowski at 6:25 of the first period. And the Leafs have a 1-0 lead. Rangers have Callahan and Boyle with Girardi and McDonough. Kessel trying to drop it back. Rangers able to get it out of the zone.
Nice play by Boyle.
Koska for Tyler Bozak. All the way around the captain, Dion Fedot. Now Kessel with a shot blocked. And Callahan chips it out of the zone. Good job by Ryan Callahan.
And by Dan Girardi. Familiar sight, limping to the bench after he blocked a shot.
Rick Nash and Jeff Halpern have come on with Stahl and Delzato. Nash looks around. Up the board, Fedot. Kadri, that's blocked by Delzato. And cleared by Halpern. Real good job blocking shots.
Again, Toronto's stuck on one shot in this period thus far. Rangers with 13.
Played over 17 minutes. Brought across by MacArthur and deep. Grabowski back up the boards. John Michael Lyles. Long shot, save, rebound, score! James Van Riemsdyk, the New Jersey kid. Gets the rebound. He put that big body in front, and it's 2-0 Toronto.
Well, Randy Carlyle had a talk with James Van Riemsdyk. He said, we want you around the net all the time. Here's the work. The shot will come from the point, and Van Riemsdyk just has too much time. He was there. Lundqvist with the first save. And then Van Riemsdyk just had a little too much time, and he's able to corral the loose puck and actually bring it to his forehand and then put it in past Lundqvist.
Wow. Three shots for the Leafs, two goals. They score on the power play and now lead 2-0. Van Riemsdyk with his third. He had two goals in a win in Pittsburgh earlier this week.
Damn, this place is stunning.
Oh, yeah.
Don't they? I mean, this place is quiet. The Rangers, with everything they've done so well this period, they trail it 2-0.
I'm just thinking the same thing, Joe. They played a good first period. Yeah. They're down by two.
Yeah.
Gabrick chasing after the puck. Koska there first. Koska is a University of Massachusetts product. Ontario native. Koska and Fedot, the defensive pair. Leafs sent down Jake Gardner, who they had hoped would be one of their rock-solid defensemen, but he was coming off a concussion, suffered from playing in the American League, and is not back to 100%. Shot by Gabrick deflects out of play. Thursday on MSG Network, it's the premiere of Beginnings. Ryan McDonough, presented by Melrose Credit Union. Thursday night, immediately following the Rangers postgame, only on MSG Network. Those are great shows. Just talk about, you can get such a personal view of the player and what it's taken to get where they are now.
Yeah, I mean, they're such great stories. How they grow up and getting to know their families and the sacrifices that they make and the family makes in order to, you know, help these kids' dreams come true.
McClement moving it to Kadri. His pass broken up by Stahl. The Leafs' second goal, Van Riemsdyk, from Lyles and MacArthur at 17:15. John Michael Lyles, an outstanding passer and point man on the power play, with two assists in the game now. Pyatt, Stepan, and Callahan the line for the Rangers. Need something good to happen before the end of the period.
Scoring a goal would be one of those things.
Tomasarek getting away from Callahan. Girardi takes over. fifth game of the season, which began a week ago. Under a minute to go in this first period. Haglin moves in with Boylan Ferriero. Ferriero in the corner. Checked by Phaneuf. Haglin puts it behind the net. Leafs take over. There's MacArthur. Girardi gets back. The shot went wide. And Haglin turns it for Boyle. Reimer to Phaneuf. Haglin tried to hit him and bounced off. That sharp angle shot by Ferriero. The rebound was put up into the crowd. That's going to be a power play for the Rangers. Tyler Bozak putting it up into the crowd.
Yeah, Sam, that's why so many coaches, and there's Randy Carlyle, the Toronto coach, but so many coaches say sometimes just throw the puck at the net and you never know what's going to happen. So Ferriero throws it at the net from a bad angle. Reimer makes a save but can't control it. And then Bozak, just trying to get it out of the way, out of midair, bats it over the glass. And maybe this is the break that you were talking about.
We'll see. Richards, Nash, Callahan, Girardi, and Delzato start the power play. Leafs able to clear. 10 seconds remaining in the period. Delay of game is the penalty at 19:35. Deflects out of play, going up into the netting. Rangers put it into the netting. The faceoff comes outside the zone. Second power play opportunity for the Rangers. Coming up, the Delta intermission report.
See Dan Girardi getting power play time as well. Remember, it's been mostly Brad Richards on the point on the power play.
Rangers skated well in that first period. Had 14 shots on goal and got nothing to show for it except a 2-0 deficit.
Now, Sam, they did a lot of good things, but they had a couple of breakdowns in their own zone as far as defensive zone coverage. And that's all it took was a couple of mistakes, and it ends up in their net, and they couldn't finish some of the great chances they had.
Coming up, the Delta Intermission Report. Our special guest will be Brian Boyle. He'll join John Giannone in the studio. Dave Maloney will join John for analysis of the first period, and Steve Gelbs has an update on the Knicks and Sixers on the Audi MSG 150. It's all coming up on the Delta Intermission Report. End of one here at Madison Square Garden. The Maple Leafs lead the Rangers 2-0.
Welcome back. It's the Delta first intermission report from Madison Square Garden, where Grabowski and Van Riemsdyk have scored to make it 2-0 Toronto after one. We're joined by Brian Boyle. And I would think when you look at the shots on goal total and the way the puck was really in their end a lot more than yours, this has to be an incredibly frustrating first period.
Yeah, a couple lapses, I think, just little mistakes that kind of can turn into big things. That's kind of where we're at right now. Some details that we need to iron out. Look like little things, and they kind of pile on. And sometimes it ends up in the back of our net. And we did some good things, but we need to shore it up a little bit.
That said, Brian, enough good in the first period to give you a sense of confidence for the last 40?
Oh, we're down two. I mean, you know, there were some good things where we should try and keep a little bit of confidence right now at this point, right where we're at as a club and our record and what's going on tonight. But we got to dig deep. We got to find a way right now and get a little bit desperate.
All right, from Twitter, one of the fans wants to know, Jenny NYR says, what are the specific things or thing you're working on given the fact that it is a shortened season?
I think it's just consistency. You know, it's every night it's got to be there. It hasn't been there yet. There's nothing to save it for. We need to be consistent every single night. We need to kind of elevate our game a little bit, sort of like a playoff mentality.
Thanks for coming in.
Thanks, Sean.
Brian Boyle joining us between periods. When we come back, we've got plenty more, including the Audi MSG 150 highlights of the Knicks and Sixers from Philadelphia. Rangers down two after 20 minutes.
We are back at Madison Square Garden, where New York Rangers hockey is presented by Chase. Sam Rosen, Joe Micheletti, John Giannone. Getting set for the second period, but first, time for our Cadillac trivia question. Phil Kessel set a career high with 82 points last season. Who was the last Leaf to reach the 80-point plateau?
Wow, that's a good question.
Matt Sundin? Anybody since then?
Yeah.
I'm going with
Nats. I don't
know. Nats.
That's a good answer.
80 points.
You've been studying.
0-1-0-2.
Yeah. Yeah, it's been a while, hasn't it?
Wow.
Well, they haven't. They're the only team to not make the playoffs since the last lockout.
Right.
Now, John Tortorella, you know, I'm sure when he looked at that first period, you know, he saw a lot of good things that his team was doing and that they probably talked about in practice, and they had a full practice this morning, which is unusual for game day, but they're trying to get practice sessions in. And I think he probably pointed most of those out. They still made a couple of mistakes in their own zone defensively, and that'll get cleared up. But I think, if anything, he's just, if they could have finished on some of the chances they had. I mean, James Reimer was the best player in that period.
Well,
you're
right.
The way he played.
14 shots for the Rangers. Rangers start the second period on the power play. 1:36 remaining in the delay of game penalty. To Tyler Bozak, Rangers have Richards, Nash, and Callahan, with Girardi and Delzato for the power play. Girardi playing it back. Delzato picks it up. Rangers' second power play of the game. First one was a good one, and three shots on goal. Richards' shot was blocked, and that clearing attempt went by Girardi, and all the way back, Delzato goes back to get it. Delzato looks, tries to hit Nash, missed connection, back the other way. Leo Komarov with a shot that gets through, that's gloved by Lundqvist, and he holds it.
Now, the penalty killing for the Leafs has been an area of concern, not just last season, but for years. And this is one of the new players they have on their roster, Komarov. He won a championship last year for Dynamo Moscow in the KHL, where he served as one of the captains. And he is one of these players that players describe as just a pest.
He buzzes around.
He gets in your face. He hits everything and tries to get you off your game.
McDonough's on now for power play time. Gavrik, Stepan, and Pyatt with Strawman and McDonough. The Rangers looking to find some combination that will click and score a goal. The Leafs able to clear all the way back. McDonough heads up ice. 20 seconds to go in the power play. Gavrik, the lead to Taylor Pyatt. Moves in by Koska's there. Koska ties him up, moves the puck. Fulleman stopped by Pyatt in the corner. Now Stepan. Pinoff is there with Koska, the two defensemen. Fulleman tried to play it. McDonough got upended by Fulleman. The puck out of the zone, and that's it. Power play is over. The Rangers fail to get a shot on goal on the power play. Second period, Leafs a 2-0 lead. Boyle sending it down. This will be an icing on the Rangers. Back the other way they go for the faceoff.
Now, Sam, the Rangers were able to generate some very good chances in the first period, but James Reimer, who played a good game in Pittsburgh, he got some help there from his defenseman, but this was his best save of the period on the breakaway by Nash. And then another deflection that he was able to stop, and then that long shot on the power play from Mark Stahl. He was able to cover up as well. Good, solid first period from James Reimer.
Kadri won the faceoff. Komarov's pass off the stick of Kadri, and out with it is Ben Ferriero. He's hit along the boards. Big hit by Boyle away from the play on John Michael Lyles. That pass broken up. Nice play by Delzato. Boyle, Haglund, and Ferriero the line for the Rangers. Good play by Boyle in the neutral zone. Haglund for Ferriero. Ferriero into the corner. Boyle, a collision behind the net with Mark Fraser. Leafs head down the other way.
Ferriero started this game on the fourth line. He got moved up quicker, partly because Rupp was in the penalty box because of his fight with Orr, but now he's staying there here in the second period.
Boyle moves in. Stahl is in deep. Puck around the boards. Ferriero is going to the bench for a change. Back the other way, Phil Kessel. His pass deflected, goes over the glass into the crowd. Gavrik got a piece of that.
Now, John Tortorella, when you listen to him talk about Brian Boyle, he says part of the thing he's got to do is play physical. And that's a good, solid hit there by Brian Boyle. Play physical, do a good job killing penalties. Overall, as a team, their face-offs, you know, they were under 50% in the first period. That's an area that they need to improve on as well.
They were better in Philadelphia.
They were until the end of the game, yeah, when they pulled their goaltender, right, and they lost three or four consecutive faceoffs.
Van Riemsdyk trying to play it ahead. Vanuf and Koska, the defensive pair for the Leafs. Girardi, Van Riemsdyk on him. Koska back to Vanuf. Lifted deep into the Rangers zone. Every time I see Dion Phaneuf, and he's a good guy and a hard hitting hockey player, a real solid player. I keep thinking about that hit on Michael Sauer.
I know.
A year ago last December.
And it's a shame that Michael Sauer is not here and playing. And he's a very, very solid defenseman. He's a top four defenseman. And it's interesting, isn't it, Sam, that the family has had so many issues. His two brothers, one playing football, the other one playing hockey. They've had serious concussion issues.
Callahan's dumping was knocked down by Komisarek, and it's whistled down for an offside on the Rangers. We're 4:24 into the second period.
And, Sam, that was a clean hit by Phaneuf well. It was a clean hit, just a hard hit by him. And meanwhile, you know, the other change for Dion Phaneuf this year, as they moved him for years, he's played the right side on defense, and they moved him over to the left side. They just think that he has better control, won't run around as much, and it's been a good combination, he and Koska.
Puck all around the boards. Rangers fourth line on here with Asham, Rupp, and Halpert. Asham tied up with Lyles along the boards. Rupp and Orr. Panora had a fight in the first period. Orr was late. Rangers had a strong first period, but gave up two goals and still trailed 2-0. This has been a slow start to this slow developing second period. Weekdays on MSG. Wake up to Boomer and Carton starting Tuesday. This week, the guys are live in New Orleans. They'll be at the site of the big game. Can I say Super Bowl? Boomer and Carton weekday mornings from 6 to 10 a.m. on MSG Network, live from New Orleans. Don't want to miss that.
Hey, Sam, by the way, a hello to Larry Brooks, our good friend who's been under the weather and hasn't been around the last few games and is getting better, but home watching.
Larry, get better
we're
soon.
We're hoping he feels better.
I thought he went to Hawaii, took some time off during the cold streak. The cold spell here. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Richards takes it back. And that's deflected by Kuhlman. Up into the netting. Faceoff stays in the Leafs.
You know, maybe he is in Hawaii, and he just told everybody he wasn't feeling well. His paper trail was good. Meanwhile, you're right, Sam. This is a different start to this period.
Rangers have yet to get a shot on goal here in the second. 5:18 gone by.
And I think this is part of the process that Randy Carlyle, the head coach, he coached 18 games a year ago with this team, and he's, you know, kind of a defense first kind of coach, and then work out from there.
Randy was brought in placing Ron Wilson, having won the Stanley Cup in Anaheim in 2007. There's Nash trying to get it through to Gabrick. Nash shoots, save Reimer. The rebound, score! Brad Richards! And the Rangers crowd the net and find the loose puck.
Well, this is make the pass up the ice and then attack. It starts with Staal. Now Nash has it, has some time, has some room. Tried to make one pass. That wasn't there, and eventually the rebound to Richards on the other side. Nash took the shot. Nobody could clear it, and Richards just following up puts it in the empty net, and there's noise in this building. The Rangers had chances in the first and couldn't score, and that was a perfect breakout and a great finish.
That line was dynamic against the Bruins last week here at the Garden, and the Rangers win. Rangers are offside coming in. Quiet in the game against Philadelphia the next night, but this is what the Rangers need. That line, when they get going, getting scoring chances.
John Tortorella just said, are you two happy playing together? They both nodded.
Richards is second from Gavrik and Nash at 5:43. The Rangers put some life in the building. There's a lead for Ferriero. Moves in on Lyles, who deflects the shot. Haglund chases it down. Lyles bumped by Boyle. Stopped by Haglund. Takeaway by Boyle. Lyles on him. Now Haglund. Hit by Fraser. Boyle picks it up. On goal. He didn't get much on the shot. Reimer stops play, covering up. 6:23 gone by, second period. The Rangers come to life on a goal by Brad Richards. A good reason to celebrate.
All right, here's Mark Staal with the puck. Now, way up here is Brad Richards. He forces Toronto to move back, and then over here you've got Nash that's going to go up the lane. So with Richards all the way up, he forces the defenseman to go back and catch him. Now they have to back in over the blue line. That allows Nash to carry the puck over the blue line, attempt one pass, get his own rebound. And the man that was at the blue line to start follows up the play, Brad Richards, and scores the goal.
And right back on the ice, Richards, Gavrik, and Nash. Rangers. Rick Nash has four shots on goal in the game. Grabowski through to Kuhlman. Kuhlman moves in on Staal. Leaves it for Van Riemsdyk. Save off the glove of Lundqvist. He had trouble with that shot. Gavrik for Nash. Nash looks, fires it through for Staal, cutting it from the point. Richards to Gavrik. Now to Nash. Save, Reimer.
Wow.
Five shots for Nash.
Oh, can he get that shot off quickly?
Grabowski, pass blocked by Staal. Hyatt went down. Koska's got it. Long shot, deflects to the corner. MacArthur out to Gunnarsson. Now Koska winds up, no shot. Gunnarsson fakes, sets up MacArthur, and it went off the bar and into the netting.
Good move by Gunnarsson there, and a good setup. And meanwhile, here's the play in deep again. Quick passes, and there's that quick release. Beautiful release by Nash. Boy, it just doesn't take him long. He gets it, and even though he's on his forehand, he just pulls it and snaps it. And unfortunately, Reimer actually made a good save.
Yeah, he really did. Rangers down 2-1. Send on Boyle, Haglund, and Callahan.
Sam,
Boyle
have we seen Stepan for a while?
No, I don't think so. Haglund chasing the puck, tipped away by Gunnarsson. Stepan is on now with Callahan.
Oh, so the faceoff. Also, the faceoff was taken.
There's a chance for Girardi. Missed. He was set up in the slot, but he missed. Girardi, quick shot saved by Reimer. Oh, the Rangers getting chances. A lot of time in the offensive zone. Here's Callahan. Callahan, Stepan, and Haglund. On for the Rangers. Haglund with a good play. Callahan turning, trying to get it back to Stepan. Callahan was taken down. McDonough with a hit. Kessel. Rangers have done a good job in the offensive zone. There's Rupp after the puck. Reimer had all kinds of trouble with it, but Gunnarsson able to intercept in front. And a hit by Ferriero. No, by Halpern. Back the other way. There's a penalty upcoming. An interference call.
Sam, I almost thought it was an innocent collision. I might be wrong, but it almost looked like two players just running into one another. The referees didn't see it that way because Bozak, who took the hit. You know what? The referee saw it correctly. Unless he was trying, you know what? He was trying to get through to get to the puck carrier that was right behind him. But Bozak didn't have the puck.
So interference the call on Jeff Halpern at 8:41. The Leafs get their third power play of the game. They're 1-for-2. Scored on the last one. Van Riemsdyk, after tipping a shot, got his own rebound and put it in.
Sam, we're seeing that around the league. I mean, these officials, you know, they've added some new rules that we've talked about.
They've tightened up on the interference.
That's right. They've tightened up on the old rules.
Yeah. 11 minutes remaining, second period. Rangers down 2-1. This is an important penalty kill. Grabowski moves in. McDonough got a piece of it. And it's whistled down, touched with a high stick, I believe.
Correct.
By McDonough.
That's right. Now shots now 19-6. Favoring the Rangers with a little over half the period
to
play.
Well.
Well, they have. They've done a lot of good things. And even, you know, we talked about the second period. It took a little while to get going, but their forecheck is starting to come. You can see it. They're controlling the puck and making plays.
Grabowski and Boyle. Rangers have Boyle, Callahan, McDonough, and Girardi. Girardi clearing all the way down. Enough back to get it. Stepan and Nash have come on. There's Dion Phaneuf. It for Van Riemsdyk on the boards to MacArthur. He falls down. Grabowski gave it away to Nash. Nash moves out with Stepan and McDonough. 3-on-2 across, now 3-on-3. That pass tipped away by Van Riemsdyk. Played by Nash in the corner. Good job by Nash. He's protecting the puck with that big body and his skates, and they can't move him. Fans love it.
Oh my gosh, what a job.
Great job by Rick Nash. He goes off. Hagelin and Callahan have come on. Van Riemsdyk after the puck. Swept away by Stahl. Elzotto pokes at it. 30 seconds remaining in the Toronto power play. Phaneuf across to Lyles. Lyles pass tipped by Elzotto. Stahl trying to move it. Kessel digging for it. Riemsdyk up the boards to Phaneuf. Across to Lyles. Out to him goes Callahan. Phaneuf to Kessel. Good hustle by Callahan. Forced a bad pass. Lyles. Side of the net. Van Riemsdyk pass smothered. Good sliding play by Delzotto. And the Rangers clear and the penalty is over.
Well, you had Kessel wide open on the other side and Delzotto with an excellent play.
No shots on goal on that power play for the Leafs. 2-1 Toronto. Nice move by Gabrick into the zone. Komarov takes it away. Leo Komarov moves out. Winds up. Big drive off the chest of Henrik Lundqvist. Koska moves it up to Matt Fratton. Now back to Carl Gunnarsson. Asim Kadre with a pass to Komarov is wide. Richards. Nash picks it up. Nash moves in. Tried to beat the defenseman Gunnarsson. Gunnarsson made a good play and sent Nash flying. That was a good job of playing the man by Carl Gunnarsson.
Yeah, real good. Last year it was Gunnarsson and Phaneuf. That was their shutdown pairing.
Halpern for Rupp. Good pass to Asham. Asham is in. And a save by Reimer, and the puck behind the net. Rupp's got it. Rupp with a shot, deflected up into the netting. Oh, what a move by Aaron Asham. He came close. 8:02 to go in the second. 2-1 Toronto.
It doesn't look like Aaron Asham has much of a chance, but how about the move all the way through, and he just simply can't lift the puck over the pad. Reimer put the pad down. Here it is again. Oh, just get it off the ice. Can't do it. Reimer makes the save. Good play.
Sam and Joe, Aaron Asham spent the entire commercial break skating around by himself, shaking his head, muttering some expletives, wondering how he didn't score, looking up at the scoreboard the whole time to try to watch the replay. They never did show it. He's still agonizing and still trying to find video evidence of how he didn't score that goal.
He did everything right except that, right?
He can watch it now, John. They just put it up on the board. But he came close, very close. Like to see moves like that. Boyle trying to get a shot off, but the whistle blew.
This might be a penalty on Toronto for playing the puck with your hand on the faceoff.
All right.
Let's see if it's Grabowski that gets the penalty.
And you'd see Randy Carlisle say, who?
Let's see. This is one of the new rules.
It's Grabowski going off.
The centerman cannot touch the puck with his hand on the faceoff. See what he does there? Unless there's contact made by another player other than the other centerman.
John, did you hear anything from Randy Carlisle?
Yeah, all he yelled out was, come on, Grabo, that's two games in a row. In other words, you should know the rule by now.
Oh, he's upset with his centerman. That's a good one. Thanks, John. So the Rangers power play opportunity here. Their third of the game, they're 0 for 2. Delzato and Girardi at the points. Callahan, Richards, and Nash up front. Delay of game, face-off violation is the penalty. Rangers down 2-1. They are out shooting Toronto 20-7 for the game. Good job at the blue line by the Leafs. Jay McClement carries in, winds up, big drive, and a good glove save by Lundqvist. Girardi sends in all the way around the boards. Richards takes over. Delzato had it go by him. Girardi back to Delzato. Richards goes off. Gabra comes on. Shot by Delzato goes wide. Callahan. Callahan, Stepan, and Gabrick on for the Rangers. Shot by Delzato, blocked by Kuhlman. Now Anton Skrullman has come in at the left point. And the puck cleared by the Leafs all the way down.
Yeah, the penalty killing for the Leafs has been good. The Rangers continue to struggle on the power play. Even though earlier, Sam, we talked about their power play was actually looked pretty good.
First one was really good. Taylor Pyatt has come on. Pyatt, Stepan, and Gabrick with Skrullman and now Ryan McDonough. Skrullman right point, McDonough left point. McDonough back to Gabrick. Pyatt set up in front. Long pass was elevated, went by Skrullman. Taken away and brought up by Phaneuf. Phaneuf with McClement. Good poke check by McDonough.
Boy, what a play by McDonough. He made that poke check so quickly and decisively that I think he surprised Phaneuf.
Taylor Pyatt is taken down by Mike Koska, and the puck cleared. Girardi fires around. The teams are back at full strength. Rangers did not get a shot on goal on that power play. Still 2-1. The Leafs lead the Rangers. 5:40 to go in the second period. Girardi. Pass tipped ahead by Ferriot. And Ferriot making his Rangers debut. He has played one game here at the Garden prior to this one. That was with the San Jose Sharks a couple of years ago. He couldn't quite remember when it was.
Well, he's got a lot of family just up near Boston.
He's got a brother that plays at Northeastern who's a draft pick of the Sharks, and another brother who's going to go to Northeastern
next week. And meanwhile, you know, we talk about Ryan McDonough. Look at Phaneuf, head up, and this is just McDonough with his great skating and intelligence just getting over there quickly and disrupting what was a two-on-one.
Love that slow-mo look, Joe.
It's great.
Love it.
Yeah. And you know what, Sam? I think that he is going to be good on the power play as his career continues, you know, to move forward. He's so smart, works on his shot all the time. You know, he sees the ice well.
Matter of confidence, you think?
That, both of those are things, actually.
Richards, Nash, and Gabrick back on. Puck lifted ahead, hit Grabowski. Brought in by Komarov, but he gave it up to Staal, taken back. Hulleman sending it to Komarov, out in front, intercepted by Richards. Gabrick wide to the left side. Nash sends it in deep. Koska pushes it ahead. The Leafs able to clear out. Bozak finds Kessel. Great play by Staal. Bozak to Kessel. Save, Lundqvist. The rebound blocked. Kessel trying to bank it in off Rick Nash. And it's cleared all the way down as the Rangers just get a stoppage of play. Big pressure from the Leafs.
No, it was close. Staal, first of all, made a very good defensive play. Kessel's got such tremendous speed. And you'll see he's got a little bit of room, and Staal has to reach out. Really makes a good defensive play without taking a penalty. And now the Leafs just keep going. Good save there by Lundqvist. And Kessel just doesn't stop. Kessel's been frustrated. He's getting scoring chances and not able to score.
Gabrick gets it out of the zone. Richards puts it into the corner, played there by Matt Fratton. Kadri on a backhanding it around the boards for Aaron Asham. Taken away by Kadri, trying to play it toward the net. Rangers blocked it. Lindor sending it ahead. Rupp intercepts. Rupp for Nashem, for Asham, and that was intercepted. Brought the other way by Carl Gunnarsson. Balzato. Asham, Rupp, and Halpern on for the Rangers. Asham around the net. Open man, Strowman, that's blocked in front. McDonough. Rangers getting some good opportunities.
Good job on the forecheck by that fourth line.
Well, they've had a couple of good shifts. Nashem had the scoring chance earlier. There's Taylor Pyatt moving in. Good poke check by Carl Gunnarsson. And Nikolai Kuhlman heads the other way. Kuhlman with Mike Brown. Brown in deep, Strowman chasing him. And a whistle.
Too many men on the ice.
Okay.
By Toronto.
It happened to the Rangers earlier. Now it's the Leafs. Called for too many men on the ice. Rangers power play coming up.
Well, we could show you a number of different replays. Fact of the matter is, there are a lot of white sweaters on the ice. Way too many. As we run it forward, you got all these, and you got five there, and you got more coming on the ice, and
at one point, you had eight skaters on the ice.
Yeah. That's an easy call.
So now Rangers power play, 0 for 3 in the game. The first power play, they had three shots on goal. The last two, they've had none. So you can see an upset Leafs head coach, Randy Carlisle. His team shorthanded here. Rangers have Richards, Nash, and Callahan with Delzato and Girardi. Leafs able to clear.
Rangers need shots. Get some shots on this power play.
Delzato. Rangers have had six shots on goal here in the second period, 20 for the game. Girardi to Delzato. Richards back to Delzato. Here's Girardi. Now Delzato. Richards, the shot. Save Reimer. Rebound. Save Reimer. Nash. Tried to get it to Richards and went between his skates. And it's taken out by Koska.
Well, that was another great scoring chance by Nash. Puck doesn't stand his stick for long. Boy, he finds the loose puck. quick release.
Six shots on goal for Rick Nash in the game. Gabrick, Hamasarek on him. Gabrick, Stepan, and Hyatt on now. With Girardi and Delzato, under a minute to go in the power play. A minute 40 to go in the period. Five players in the corner. Leafs killing time. Rangers pry it loose. Delzato moves. Girardi, that's a pass deflected by Gabrick, a save, and the rebound was cleared away before Gabrick could get to it. Gabrick, Stepan. Now Gabrick, 30 seconds in the power play. Girardi and Delzato, they've been on the full power play. Girardi shoots, save, Reimer, no rebound. Four shots on goal on this power play.
Now, Sam, here's a look from our Colt Zero goal cam. Are the Rangers moving the puck around? And you'll see Nash right in the middle of your screen. Rebound, there's the quick release from Nash, and Reimer with another good save.
Grab an ice cold Coke Zero, real Coca-Cola taste, but with zero calories. It's possible. 23 seconds to go on the power play. Nash back on with Richards and Callahan. McDonough and Strawman. This has been a good power play for the Rangers. Again, unable to break through. Face-off win by Richards. Strawman. Now McDonough. Feeds Richards. Callahan set up in front. Under a minute to go in the period. Richards all the way through for Strawman. Off his stick out of the zone. Strawman recovers, but the Rangers running out of time on the power play. And that will do it. They go 0 for 4 now on the power play in the game. Still 2-1 Leafs. Coming up following the end of the period, the New York Lottery intermission report. Long shot by Nash, gloved by Reimer. Don't forget Tuesday night on MSG Network. Here they come, the Flyers coming to town. They beat the Rangers the other night. They're leading in Florida tonight. Rangers and Flyers at the Garden on MSG Network. It all begins with Visa. Rangers game night at 6:30 with Al Trotwig. And then Rangers and Flyers.
Flyers lose another defenseman, Andre Mazzaros.
Yeah.
And the Rangers got hurt his shoulder. He's out for a month.
We've had a lot of injuries. Mike Knubel, as we mentioned during the game the other night, signed by the Flyers. The injuries they've had up front. Played into the Rangers zone. Gunnarsson chasing after it. Ferriero gets there first. Boyle is there. Boyle digging, trying to get it loose. Final seconds of the period. And that's it. Rangers are out shooting the Leafs 25-9. But the Leafs have two goals and lead the Rangers 2-1. End of two. Rangers got one goal in the second period by Brad Richards, and still have to find a way to be more consistent.
Well, again, the big line I thought was really good for the Rangers in that period. Richards scored the goal, but Nash was all over the place, controlling play, and they just have to continue doing what they're doing, forecheck and create scoring chances.
New York Lottery intermission report is coming up. Al Trotwig's downstairs. He hopes to have James Van Riemsdyk with him. Dave Maloney will join Al and break down the second period. Steve Gelbs will tell you how the Knicks are doing against the 76ers on the Audi MSG 150. All on the New York Lottery intermission report, which begins right now with Al.
Okay, Sam, we do have James Van Riemsdyk here. Your take on this game so far?
Yeah, you know, we got to get a couple more shots through. We've been playing pretty solidly otherwise, but, you know, we got to create some more offense.
And yet you're winning.
Yeah, you know, it's just one of those games. We got to keep staying tight defensively and make simple plays.
So what is a Jersey guy and a Ranger fan think about playing in the hockey capital of Canada?
Yeah, you know what? It's great so far. Canada's a great spot. Toronto's a great city, and I'm excited to be there.
Tell us something we don't understand about the pressure you feel to play for this team in that city that we might not get because we're in New York.
You know what? I don't quite look at it that way. I mean, obviously, it's a great opportunity. People in Canada are really passionate about their hockey, and I try to thrive off that passion they have.
Thanks.
Thank you.
James Van Riemsdyk. Sam, back to you.
Toronto Maple Leafs have taken advantage of their opportunities. They have a 2-1 lead. End of two. The rest of the New York Lottery Intermission Report is coming up. Welcome back to Madison Square Garden. Getting set for the third period, Rangers and Leafs. And New York Rangers hockey is presented by Chase. Rangers have had chances, a lot of chances in this game. Rick Nash has been at the heart of it. He's played a good all-around game.
Sam, every time he's on the ice, something happens. I mean, he's skating, he's taking hits, getting involved in the plays, he's creating offense. I mean, it's amazing that the number of things that he can do and do well. Gets in the open, had this chance. This is a great save by Reimer. That was in the first period. But he'll use his size when he gets a chance as well. Here's the play he makes that led to the goal. He gets an assist on that. He's killed penalties and really been effective. We've talked about how he's able to get the shot off quickly. This is killing the penalty. The work he does here. Two guys trying to get the puck, using his size and his strength. Seven shots on goal for Rick Nash.
Rangers 25 shots through two periods. Through the first four games, they'd average 26.8, so definitely a sign of improved offensive play. More time in the offensive zone, creating more chances. Now they've got to put the puck in the net.
Sam, I think if they just focus on making sure they're nice and solid defensively in their own zone, they're getting plenty of chances. You know, they're just going to have to keep doing that, but not get too over anxious and lose their patience with their defensive game.
All right, third period begins with Richards, Nash, and Gabrick. Stahl and Delzato for the Rangers. Mikhail Grabowski, who has one of the two Leafs goals, on with Nikolai Kuhlman and James Van Riemsdyk. Van Riemsdyk with the other goal. Mike Koska and Dion Phaneuf. The defensive pair for the Leafs. Gabrick feeding Nash. On goal, just a little wide of the net. Into the corner. Delzato tried to keep it in. Van Riemsdyk sending it in. Nice interview with Alan James Van Riemsdyk. And the young man saying he wants to thrive on the pressure of playing in Toronto. And the way the fans embrace hockey. And he wants to thrive off of that.
Well, he got a little bit of taste of it in Philadelphia. That's not exactly a place where they're passive regarding their hockey.
A lot of passion, no doubt. Berrio stopping MacArthur. Girardi trying to move it ahead. Rangers have Berrio, Callahan, and Pyatt on. Kessel moves in with a shot. Save, Lundqvist.
That might have been deflected a little bit off the stick of Girardi.
Koska will work it ahead. Callahan stopped it. McDonough to Girardi and back. McDonough leaves it for Richards, whose shot deflected by Koska. Nash in the corner against Nazem Kadri. And Kessel able to take it. Brought in by Kadri. McDonough stays with him, rides him down. Koska isn't bashful, is he, Joe? Man, he just jumps right into the play, pinches in.
Played a good game.
Pretty impressive. Nash looking to make a play. Trying to drop it off for Richards. A little miscommunication there.
Sam, Koska was the last cut at Florida's camp a year ago. So he's been close to breaking into the National Hockey League.
The giveaway. Stepan with a shot that was blocked. It hit Dion Phaneuf. That's fired through. Girardi. Wrister deflected into the corner. Boyle's got it.
Enough's having trouble skating.
Carl Hagelin. Phaneuf goes in front of the net. And you're right, he's limping a little bit, but staying on. Long shot saved by Reimer. Stahl with a tough, low shot. And Reimer stayed with it.
Yeah. Stepan was there. I'm not sure he didn't get a piece of that as well. Good forecheck. There's the work. Yeah, it looked like Stepan deflected it.
Right.
Reimer was in good position. Here it is again. Nice low shot. Good redirection by Derek Stepan.
Stepan could use a goal right about now, couldn't he?
Yeah, he could. And he understands, you know, what his role is and the importance of his role on this team.
Ferriero has been moved up to play with Callahan and Pyatt here.
Ferriero started the game on the wing, now he's playing center.
Puck sent down the ice will be an icing on the Leafs. And we have a timeout, so we have time to go down to John Gianone on Ford between the benches. John.
Well, Sam, I spoke with assistant coach Mike Sullivan on the way out to the ice. His assessment was a lot like Joe's. He said, stay with it. Don't really change anything. Do more of the same. And, quote, we will score. When I asked him about the power play, he said it's the best they've looked so far despite the 0-for-4. They've gotten a lot of chances. He said we need to make better decisions at the top half of the ice on the power play. And certainly it starts and ends with winning faceoffs.
Thanks, John. Check out the best-selling vehicles in America. Visit your Tri-State Ford dealer today.
Well, the big change in their power play, and I think it's been better, is that they've utilized more defensemen.
Right.
Girardi getting power play time. McDonough stall a little bit.
And using Girardi with Delzato as the number one point pair.
And he, and Anton Strawman has gotten
right.
some power play time as well.
Kuhlman, Leafs with two goals in the first period. A period in which the Rangers outshot the Leafs 14-3, and the Leafs came out with a 2-0 lead. Second period, Rangers got the goal by Richards, and that's where we stand, the 2-1. Started three straight on home ice for the Rangers. Tuesday night, Philadelphia Flyers will be here, and Thursday night, the Pittsburgh Penguins. Long pass tipped by Ferriero, picked up by Callahan, saved by Reimer. Long breakout pass, and Callahan had a chance.
Well, Ferriero is caught on quickly because he's moved at center, and this is a play that the Rangers have used where the centerman goes all the way up to the offensive zone and then leaves the offensive zone. Here he is here. He'll time it to go this way, and then he'll deflect it. So here comes the long pass. There's a little deflection that leads to this chance, and Callahan has the backhand opportunity.
Haglin moved in for the faceoff. Leafs come away with it. Matt Fratton lost it to Callahan. Now Fratton with the lead to Kadri. Kadri shot blocked by Girardi. Shaking his right hand. Ferriero's pass taken away by Kadri. High shot fought off with a right shoulder by Lundqvist. Kadri battling Girardi. Girardi was able to kick it to McDonough. The Rangers come out. Callahan. Reimer, who has been the Leafs' best player in the game. He has stopped 27 of 28. Lyles playing it back to Fraser.
He really looked solid. He was in goal for their win in Pittsburgh. Played well there. Boy, they don't talk about much else with the exception of goaltending. In Toronto,
yeah,
do they,
absolutely.
Sam? There's still so much talk about Roberto Luongo and ending up there, but if Reimer continues to play this way, they won't make the deal.
And the question in that possible deal is, what do you give up?
Right. Well, initially, there's a lot of talk that they wanted Kadri, and they weren't willing to give him up, and he's off to an excellent start.
Leafs turn it around. Brown's pass intercepted by Stepan. Lozano and tried to dump it in and gave it away, and then the Leafs transition the other way. This is an icing on the Rangers.
See, this is a new play as well, where they call the icing if it doesn't touch the stick. As long as you have two hands in your stick and you attempt to play the puck, and if it doesn't touch your stick, it bounces over. A lot of times you used to wave those
right.
off. They don't wave those off anymore.
Boyle and McClement on the faceoff. 5:39 gone by. Third period. Rangers down 2-1. Stahl swings it around for Taylor Pyatt. The line here is Boyle, Pyatt. Stepan is on. They had two centers on for the faceoff. Now Boyle goes to the bench. The Rangers complete the change. Richards comes on now with Nash. Gavrin. Hulaman into the corner, stall on him. Behind the Rangers net, Strahlman chases after it. Grabowski takes it back. Good pass to Van Riemsdyk, out to Fanouf, a high shot, and went wide, bangs off the glass. Played back by Van Riemsdyk, Strahlman takes over. And Nash gets it out of the zone. Fanouf getting it out. And a 3-on-2 across for Toronto. And Riemsdyk backhands it toward the net, deflected wide. Grabowski driving hard to the net. Gunnarsson moves it across to Komisarek. Back through to Carl Gunnarsson for the drive. Glove save by Lundqvist with big James Van Riemsdyk right in front. Good save. 6:53 gone by in the third. 2-1 Leafs.
Well, talk about being thrown into the fire. Vince Ferriero, which is exactly what you want when you're given the opportunity. And again, he started this game on the fourth line on wing. Then he was moved up to the third line, played wing, and now he's the center iceman. Doing a little bit of everything.
Getting a taste of everything.
Yeah.
And actually, he's done a nice job.
Sure he has.
And it's been quite a week for him, having started out in Wilkes-Barre, went up to Hartford, and now in New York. Alpert chased from the faceoff circle, and Callahan comes in to take it.
Grabowski trying to draw the puck right behind him to Van Riemsdyk.
Grabowski wins the draw to Gunnarsson. There's Komisarek off the end boards, chipped away by McDonough. The Rangers come out. Nice pass from Alpert to Haglund. Haglund with Callahan, gloved by Van Riemsdyk, by Reimer, excuse me. And he holds on. Tuesday night, right here, on MSG Network. It's the Rangers and the Philadelphia Flyers. It all begins at 6:30 with Visa Rangers game night with Al Trotwig. And then it's the Rangers and the Flyers, the rematch, presented by Chase. Flyers, last I saw,
4-1 is
4-1.
Yeah,
right. As they try to make it 2 in a row.
Florida's having a tough time. They won their first game and then what, lost 4 in a row? I think they're 1-4 going in this one, or 1-3?
I'm not sure, but 1-4. Let's see. Quick look at Florida, 1-3. With only 7 goals scored in the 4 games. Gunnarsson ahead for McClement. Picked up by Nikolai Kuhlman. Stahl is there. Got the shot off, saved by Lundqvist. Grabowski winds it in the corner. Here's Kuhlman. Finds Grabowski. Boy, they work well together. Kuhlman.
They're hoping Kuhlman gets back to the level he was a couple years ago when he had 30 goals. He had just 7 last year.
Gavrik moves in. Now deep to the setup, score! Mark Stahl! Two defensemen, Delzato and Stahl, go to the net and make it happen.
I was going to say, when you need offense, send everybody. It starts with them breaking out of their own zone, making the play, and both Stahl and Delzato take off with the play. Beautiful passing. I mean, this is a beautiful goal. Toronto had all 5 players back. Gavrik to Delzato to Stahl to tie it.
First goal by a Rangers defenseman this season. What a beautiful play. And great to see the confidence of Delzato and Stahl to just join the rush.
Richards was the forward that stayed back on defense.
So the Rangers have come back to tie it. You can hear the excitement in the building. And buzzing around the net was Derek Stepan. Here's McDonough with a wrister that's deflected off the glass and out of play.
That one hit Pyatt, and so the faceoff will be outside the zone.
Mark Stahl gets the goal. The Rangers have 30 shots on goal. Delzato and Gabrick get the assist at 7:36. Two assists in the game by Marion Gabrick.
Yeah, remember John Tortorella talking about Mark Stahl and looking at video of him 2 years ago when he was healthy and joining the rush and getting involved with more offense. Well, he moved up perfectly there.
You can hear the crowd with a Let's Go Rangers chant as McDonough reverses to Girardi. Down the ice it goes. This will be an icing on the Rangers. If Komisarek beats Haglund to it, and he does. 8:14 gone by here in the third period. Rangers out shooting the Leafs 30-13.
Sam, you know, we're going to start here. You get a defenseman here, and you get a defenseman here. The puck is going to go this way, and Stahl is going to make the play, and then watch how they both react. Makes the play, and they both lead the rush. Here they are, leading the rush. Delzato ends up getting the pass from Gabrick. He feeds his partner. Looked easy, didn't it?
And Nash is saying, what about me, guys? I'm supposed to be the goal scorer here.
He just, there are a lot of other eyes that were on him, paying attention to him. It leaves a few other players open.
Well, you used the term earlier, Joe, decisive. And there was no hesitation on that play at all by the Rangers.
I think that's been part of their problem in the early going, just a little hesitation at times on all ends of the ice.
Puck was knocked away from Callahan. Good hustle play by Ferriot. Kessel able to move it across. Callahan sends it back in. Game tied 2-2. Rangers trailed 2-0 into the first period. Pinot fakes the shot, moves in. He shoots, save, Lundqvist around the net. It's good play. Coming back by Richards as he checked Kessel at the side of the net.
It was wide open net. That would have been a little tap in. Good play by Knuff on the rush.
Nash with a pass to Gabrick. Gabrick drops it off to Richards. Richards shot wide. That was a pass actually for Nash. Nash comes off the boards, turns, a shot blocked by Kessel. Grabowski comes out with it.
That would be one of those accidental block shots. Kessel was limping as he skated off.
Coming down to the midway point, third period. The game tied 2-2. Long pass up the boards. Rangers take it back. Tipped into the Leaf zone. Reimer out to get it. Let's Go Rangers chant up for the crowd. Good forecheck pressure. Pyatt gets knocked down as he tried to get to the net. Boyle battling Lyles behind the net. Now Pyatt in the corner. Pyatt comes out with a puck. Pyatt trying to get in front. It was cleared aside by Fraser. Kept in by McDonough. Pyatt against Lyles. Good work by this line, which is Boyle, Stepan, and Pyatt. Pyatt shoots, save, Reimer, and he holds it. 9:42 to go, third period. Rangers have ramped it up. They've tied the game at 2.
Dion Phaneuf almost gives Toronto lead. Watch the fake shot, gets Delzato to fight, but then Delzato doesn't give up on it. And then there's the play you talked about in front, Sam, with Richards coming over. Watch a stick here of Delzato. Just gets a piece of it. Puck stays low, but Phaneuf continues, and then Richards with the defensive play to save a goal.
I really like the way Delzato has started the season.
He's
been responsible
mature
defensively.
Yeah.
And now you see him take advantage of opportunities offensively.
He's just maturing, Sam. You know, he's just growing up, 22 years of age.
Here's Delzato. Save, Reimer, with Nash screening in front. Rangers have Richards, Gabrick, and Nash with Delzato and Stahl. Gail Grabowski overskated. Puck stopped by Koska. Koska's pass deflection, a save with a left pad by Lundqvist. Delzato moves it up and out of the zone.
The Rangers were briefly shorthanded there as Gabrick had to go to the bench for another stick. That left that side open. And the easy shot, which led to the redirection by Van Riemsdyk.
9 minutes to go, third period, game tied, 2-2. Stahl drops it back, hits the stick that was on the ice. Delzato able to play it. for Staal. And the Rangers, a troublesome moment, but get it out of the zone after the puck hit that stick on the ice. Mike Komisarek. In the corner, Haglund. Haglund takes a hit. Kessel up the boards to Carl Gunnarsson. Now Komisarek. Turning is Kessel, shot blocked by Callahan, drops down the corner and hit the netting. And play stops. Coming up, it's the Foxwoods Final Five. Foxwoods, your destination for endless excitement. Visit foxwoods.com now. Rangers, looking at Carl Haglund, he skated well in this game. And Rangers as a team have overall have played a good game. They just fell behind early.
Yeah, I agree, Sam. And I think the other thing is that Henrik Lundqvist, to me, he hasn't been nearly as busy as James Reimer. But he's made some key saves in these last couple of periods, in particular that last one on the redirection by Van Riemsdyk.
Boyle on the faceoff. Boyle has been the best faceoff man for the Rangers in the game. Boyle with a hit along the boards. And the Rangers clear it out.
Well, that's what he's doing when he's playing well. Winning some faceoffs, playing physical.
Rangers almost forced the turnover. Puck is put up into the Leafs bench and the faceoff comes back in the Leafs zone. 8:02 to go, third period. With the game tied 2-2.
Yeah, Lundqvist again in this game. He's had to go long stretches without seeing any shots. And so he's really kept his concentration and his focus. He's just starting to look now like he did all of last season.
Boyle, Pyatt, and Stepan. Line from the Rangers, driven hard around the boards, blocked and kept in by Girardi. In the corner, Pyatt and Fanouk. Up the boards, McDonough with a shot blocked by Koska. The rebound was poked at and missed and blocked.
I think it hit the skate of Fanouk.
Stepan that poked it, looking to poke it in the net. Out to McDonough. Now Girardi with a wrister, saved by Reimer, and he has the rebound.
Boy, nice job in front, too, by Taylor Pyatt. I'm not sure Reimer saw that or he was late picking it up because of the presence of Pyatt in front. And then here's the other work. Let's see if it doesn't hit. Yeah, see, it hits the left skate of number three, Dion Phaneuf. You'll see his left skate right there. And that prevents it from getting to the goaltender.
Richards, Gabrick, and Nash back on. Phaneuf taking a moment here.
He's going to have sore feet at the end of this one. He's been hit a number of times in the feet with shots.
Puck out to the point and out of the zone. Staal has it back. Staal and Delzato on defense. Sent in by Nash on goal, stick to side by Reimer. Grabowski tried to move it. Kuhlman battling in the corner with Nash. Nash wins it. Up the boards, Richards to Staal. He scores! I believe Marion Gaborik deflected it in. Rangers lead 3-2.
I'll tell you what, this starts with Rick Nash. Watch the strength of Nash here, fighting this off, staying with it, staying with it, staying with it. Eventually they work it back to the point and Gaborik will get a piece of it right there. Perfect shot to deflect. But Nash did most of the work in the corner. Just when it looked like Toronto might have had time to clear the puck out of the zone, Nash was so strong on his stick that kept the play alive.
Nash won't get an assist on the play, but he certainly made it happen with his strong play along the boards. Gaborik got to the front of the net. Looks like Richards will get an assist. And Staal with a shot, which was a really good shot.
Yeah, nice and low.
Ferriero plays it to McDonough. Now Girardi toward the net, blocked in front. Rangers try to find it, poked ahead, batted down, taken back, shot by Haglund, save by Reimer.
Sam, the Maple Leafs have not been able to handle the Rangers in front of the net.
And this line has done a nice job. Wrap around by Haglund, stopped by Reimer. They have skated well. They really hustled. And that's Ferriero, Haglund, and Callahan.
Yeah, not a big line, but quick.
Picked up by McDonough. 6 minutes to go in the third, and the Rangers leading for the first time, 3-2. Puck deflects out of play, 5:52 to go. Marian Gaborik gets his fourth goal of the season. He's had a three-point night, and the Rangers have a 3-2 lead.
John Giannone back at the Garden, and those three guys right there, Richards, Nash, and Gaborik, they might have to go see the trainer after this game, Joe and Sam, because they received such hard pats on the back from their head coach after that goal for a job well done. John Tortorella really gave it to them when they got to the bench, and that's as animated as I've seen the head coach all year after that goal was scored.
Well, that line had a great game against Boston, as we mentioned, with 15 shots on goal. That line has had another solid game tonight with two goals, Gaborik and Richards. Gaborik has two assists, Richards has an assist, and Nash has an assist. Nash has 8 shots on goal. Pretty good effort.
Yeah, and you know what, Sam? They've been good in their own zone. In particular, yeah. That game-saving or that goal-saving defensive play by Richards on Kessel.
Kadri playing it through. McClellan for Matt Fratton. 5:20 to go, third period. Fratton goes down. Girardi tied up along the boards by McClellan. Boyle moved it up. Boyle, Pyatt, and Stepan the line for the Rangers. As Stepan moved to right wing. Gunnarsson for Toronto. Under the 5 minute mark. Playing it over to Koska. Now Leon Phaneuf. Rangers have held the Leafs to just 15 shots on goal for the game.
Good defensive hockey here. The Rangers starting the neutral zone. They back Toronto all the way in their own end. And there's good back pressure by Richards there. Richards has had his best game, without question.
Hrabowski moves in. Slides it through to Van Riemsdyk. He's checked there by Callahan. On the boards, Haglund. Lozano takes the puck. Around for Ferriero. They're here with just over 4 minutes to go. Ferriero in his Rangers debut getting good ice time. Callahan. Glove saved by Reimer. Another good chance. And Reimer comes up big. After the game, join Al Trotwick, Dave Maloney, Billy Jaffe, Ken Danico. Post-game analysis, Rangers and Leafs. A look around the league and what's going on Hockey Night Live. Right after the game, we're here on MSG Plus.
How about San Jose winning again?
4 wins. Patrick Marleau has 2 goals in each of the first 4 games. Wow.
Pretty good start.
They're 4-0. Chicago Blackhawks have gotten off to a good start. The Devils have gotten off to a good start.
LA Kings scored 4 goals in their first 3 games. They've got 3 tonight. In Phoenix.
Haglund.
Oh, this couldn't work.
Good puck possession by the Rangers. Couple of chances for Callahan. Reimer stopped the first, second one went wide.
Sam, you noticed it early when this line was put together. That they were playing well. They continue it here. Ferriero.
Good skaters. Kessel moves in. Girardi with a good play. Stepan sends it in. And good hustle to the puck along the boards by Taylor Pyatt. Along the boards, Komarov checking Boyle. Stepan trying to move it. Komarov went down. Boyle behind the net with Stepan. Out to Delzato. Big drive. Block. Delzato again. He scores! The Rangers defense coming through. 4-2, Rangers lead.
What work on the forecheck. The Rangers have worn down this Toronto team in their own zone. Boyle on one side, Pyatt there as well. Look at the hard work, and they just stopped and start and stopped and start, and eventually the pass. First one's blocked, and then the great wrist shot. How did that get through? What a shot. Perfect. Leaned into that one. Oh, you know
did
what?
It hit Boyle?
It might have hit Boyle. That's how
all
it
right.
got through.
That big body
Maybe.
In front. I mean,
yeah.
it could have easily hit him. He takes up so much space. But Delzato making good plays. The Rangers, the way they've controlled the puck, Joe.
That's a big key. We've heard the coaches, the players talk about holding on to the puck and making plays. They're doing that in this game.
You're watching the Foxwoods Final Five. Foxwoods, your destination for endless excitement. Visit foxwoods.com now. Lundqvist stops play at the side of the net. Rangers have a 4-2 lead with 2:18 to go. Three goals here in the third period for the Rangers.
Shots 41-16. And it would seem like it's been easy, but it hasn't been.
No, not at all. Stahl, Gaborik, and now awaiting the announcement on the fourth goal, either Delzato or Boyle.
Boyle's played his best game.
Yes, he has.
Richards has played his best game.
Yeah.
The defense getting more involved in the offense.
A lot of positives in this game. This is an icing on the Rangers with 2:12 to go. Brian Boyle gets credit for the goal. Blue Shirts fans, follow the team wherever you go and download the official Rangers mobile app, complete with exclusive team video, photo galleries, player features, interactive schedule, and a whole lot more. Leafs have pulled the goaltender. James Reimer has gone to the bench with 2:10 to go. Six skaters on for Toronto. Rangers with a two-goal lead. Clear the puck down and icing is whistled. 2:03 to go. Both teams have their timeouts. Boyle gets the goal from Delzato and Stepan at 17:08. Delzato with two assists in the game. And Brian Boyle taking the faceoff. He's been on for several key faceoffs in this game. And he wins that one. Lifted out by Haglund.
Boyle wins the faceoff, heads to the bench. And Richards comes on.
Enough. And the Leafs are offside, 1:45 to go. Leafs net is empty. Rangers fell behind 2-0 in the first period. Leafs scored two goals on their first three shots of the game. Like Reimer is going to go back between the circles.
Yeah, with the face-off.
Face-off.
Right.
He's ready to go to the bench if the Leafs can put it in the Rangers' zone. But the Rangers gain control. Koska. Alfinov. And Kessel. Reimer to the bench. And the Leafs' net is empty with 1:28 to go. Rangers leading 4-2. Six players in the corner. Puck pops loose. Rick Nash has it. Nash lifts it ahead for Gaborik. Gaborik to the empty net. He scores! Marian Gaborik now has 5 goals on the season.
How about the unselfish play by Rick Nash? Rick Nash, when he got the puck, he looked up, he had a quick look, and he knew exactly what he was doing. Up and over everybody, knowing Gaborik was flying in down that left wing.
That line continues to impress, Joe, with Nash doing everything.
He was great tonight. He was just unbelievable.
2 goals, 2 assists for Marian Gaborik in the game. Rangers with a 5-2 lead. And they've got to feel very good about this effort. This is probably their best all-around effort of the season, I would
think. I agree, Sam. Again, they looked closer to what we saw last year. All the way there yet, but yeah. Some of the things they've done much better than they had in the previous four games.
And we said it earlier, even when they fell behind, there's a penalty coming up for the Rangers. Even when they fell behind 2-0 in the first period, they really played well. Stepan's going for hooking with 45.3 remaining in the game. The Rangers leading 5-2. Gabrick with his second of the game, an empty net goal, his fifth of the season. He has 2 goals and 2 assists in the game, assisted by Nash, who has 2 assists in the game at 18:45. Stepan for hooking at 19:14.
Now you go back over this game, and you know, as well as they played in the first, and they trailed 2-0, and this place was quiet. And I think John Tortorella and Mike Sullivan, I think they did a really good job in between periods, and then with the move that he made, putting Ferriero up on that other line, solidify, give him another line that had some energy.
That was Ferriero moving up with Haglin and Callahan,
right.
And they skated
right.
Very well.
Right.
Power play Toronto. They're 1-for-3 on the power play in the game. And they're on their feet at the Garden, cheering the Rangers. It's been a solid effort. And the Rangers about to win their second game of the season. Shot by Koska, blocked by McDonough. 5 seconds to go. Another shot, a deflection, and it went off the post and out, and it's all over. The Rangers defeat the Toronto Maple Leafs 5-2. A real good effort by the New York Rangers. Henrik Lundqvist's second win of the season. He made 15 saves in the game. The Leafs had the lead at the end of the first and had the lead going into the third period. Rangers score 4 goals in the third period, including the empty net goal, and win it 5-2.
Wasn't there a movie called titled Waiting to Exhale?
Yes.
Kind of fits.
And the team to center ice to salute the crowd. A good effort, start of a 3-game homestand, and a good start for the Rangers, who are now 2-3 on the season. We'll have the announcement of the 3 stars of the game coming up, and you can take your pick. Nash, Lozano, Gabrick has got to be one.
That's a good point, because you can go down the lineup and say best game of the season, best game of the season, yeah. Best game of the season. You know, those were the things that were happening. You know, they just, you know, they stayed with it despite some adversity in the first period. But again, their forecheck was more aggressive. And they just got to a point where you almost felt sorry for the Toronto Maple Leafs in their own zone.
Our 3 stars of the game brought to you by your Mercedes-Benz Tri-State dealers. Visit on the web at searchmercedes.com. And Brad Richards with a goal and an assist.
And some great defensive plays.
Mark Stahl, certainly deserving. A goal and an assist for him. Is the second star. And I would say Mr. Gabrick will be our number one star. Here he is. 8 points for the line of Gabrick, Richards, and Nash. Another terrific game for them. In both wins, they have been the leaders. The Rangers with an impressive win. And we've got a whole lot more coming up here in Madison Square Garden. Don't you go away. Rangers win it 5-2. Want the inside scoop on how the Rangers beat the Leafs? Stay tuned, because Mercedes-Benz Rangers postgame is coming up. John Chianone with player interviews. We'll hear from head coach John Tortorella, Joe Micheletti, and Dave Maloney. We've got analysis on Hockey Night Live with Al Trotwig, Dave Maloney, Billy Jaffe, and Ken Danico. Rangers beat the Leafs 5-2, and for how it happened, let's go to Hockey Night Live right now.